You know, that's troubling always because we're in such blessing and everything's comfortable and we have so many blessings. So it's important to remember that this is the nature of dunya. What's different about our time than other times is that we have television, we have 24-hour news cycle, we're exposed to all these things. But the Muslims throughout their history, if you look at their history, when there were some of the most flourishing times in one place were the worst times in other places. This is a human condition. What's happened now is it's globalized. Imam an-Nawawi radiallahu anhu was living during a very difficult time for Central Asians. Imam al-Ghazali was writing his great works during the occupation of Palestine. I mean, people forget that the Crusaders were in the Muslim lands while Imam al-Ghazali was really flourishing as an intellectual, as a spiritual genius, and all of the other things that he contributed. So it's important for us to keep that in mind, because some people, these events literally drive them into a type of madness. They lose their stability, they lose their balance. Because they are very trying for people, and certainly for the people in them. The best thing that we can do, obviously, is be advocates and make dua, especially. Dua is a dua silahul mu'min. Prophet ﷺ said that dua is the silahul mu'min. It's the weapon of the believer. I mean, this hadith that the usuli scholars say, asr al-kalam al-haqiqa, that the foundation of speech is literal. That you should take things literal before you move to any figurative interpretation. So if the Prophet said, "Ad-du'a silahul mu'min," that's exactly what he meant. The du'a is the weapon of the believer. Not the sword, not the spear, not the tank, those are material weapons. But the real weapon of the believer, as-silah, the real silahul mu'min, is his connection or her connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you have that connection, the Prophet's dua was also وَمِنَ الْيَقِينِ مَا تُهَوُّن بِهِ عَلَيْنَا مَصَائِبَ الدُّنْيَا. Give us the yaqeen that makes all of the tribulations of this world insignificant. وَمِنَ الْيَقِينِ مَا تُهَوِّنُ بِهِ عَلَيْنَا مَصَائِبَ الدُّنْيَا. If you have yaqeen in your heart, if you have certainty, then the calamities of this world are exactly what they are. They're calamities of this world. And anything that happens in this world is hayyan in relation to what happens in the next world. Here, our fitan are always limited. They have a beginning, a middle, and an end. In the akhirah, it's not like that. And Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu said, in every tribulation are three blessings. It could have been worse. You lost one hand, you could have lost both hands. You lost one eye, you could have lost both eyes. You broke your back, you could have lost your life, right? It always could be worse. And then that it's in the dunya, right? It's in the, as long as it's in this world, it's easy in relation to the next world. And then it's in worldly matters and not in religious matters. Because the real tribulation is when your deen is tried. People that lose their faith, people that's the real tribulation. As long as you have faith, everything is easy. So, you know, think about our brothers and sisters next door, make dua for them. And so make dua for them, also for the president, you know, for the leaders of the country. Wallahi, the Abu Hanifa radiallahu anhu, he said that if you you know, many of the scholars said this, but they said that the dua, that if you have a dua mustajab, you should do it for the leaders of the Muslims. You know, do it for the leaders. One of the, you know, I wanted somebody to do this. Nobody ever did it for me. I asked some people to do it. But in the haram, I wanted to do a decibel count on the du'as. Because, you know, everybody says ameen, and they're higher on certain things and lower on other things. Right? So like when they say, oh Allah, save us from the fire, everyone will, ameen, it goes way, way up. Then when it says, Allahumma aslih wulata umurina, you know, it all goes way down when they ask for them to, you know, to bless their rulers. And, you know, but if they really, this is a sign that we don't have common sense anymore. Because with their rectification is the rectification of the ummah. You know, the ulama say that it's the ahmaq who makes a dua against rulers. It's the fool, because the ruler's tawfiq is your tawfiq. If he has tawfiq, then the community has tawfiq. If he doesn't have tawfiq, everybody suffers from that. Undeniably, there were periods of fitnah, and we went through similar problems that other religions have had. But how did they arrive to these agreed upon things? This is not to deny that there are people, dissenters. There are, and they, if they were of a caliber that the other ulama recognized their right to dissent, they would acknowledge it. But if they were heretics, they would call it what it was, right? Heraseia is a Greek word, zandaqa is used in Arabic, but heraseia in Greek means to choose for yourself. A heresy is where you pick and choose your religion. You don't accept what's transmitted, what's agreed upon. And so in the aqidah, this is what they came. They came to the Ash'ari, the Maturidi. The Ottoman Dola was Maturidi. The Muhammad al-Fatih, he came into this city and conquered this city. The Prophet praised him. He said, Ni'm al-Amir. He said, Ni'm al-Jaysh wa Ni'm al-Amir. Ni'm al-Amir wa Amiruhum wa Ni'm al-Jaysh Jayshuhum. What a blessed Amir is their Amir, and what a blessed army is their army. He was, by consensus, Hanafi, Maturidi, and Naqshbandi. So the Prophet was praising a Hanafi, Maturidi, Naqshbandi. And people say, bid'ah, mubtada'. Astaghfirullah. Would the Prophet praise a mubtada'? He would never praise a mubtada'. And yet we know he praised the conqueror of this city. He said, Ni'ma al-Amir. Ni'ma is the way the Arabs say, the best. That's the best Amir, their Amir. And he would never praise worldly things, not like he was a great general, which he was. No, he was praising his iman. He was praising his aqidah. He was praising his practice, because he was imamun adil, and sab'atun yadhilluhum Allah yawma la dhilla illa dhilluhum. Seven are given the shade of Allah on the day of judgment, when there's no shade except Allah's shade. The first, imamun adil, a just ruler. That's how high their maqam is. A high ruler. The dhikr of the umara is adal. That's their dhikr, to practice justice. They don't have to do a lot of subha, even though he did, or do a lot of tilawa, even though he did, qiyam. They don't have to do any of that. If they're just, that's their dhikr. And they reach these high maqams. So that was who he praised. So this transmission